What is the type of epiphysis in A, B, and C? Hi and welcome to the Air Anatomy channel. I'm Dr. Doris and today we'll be learning about the types of epiphysis. Epiphysis are classified into four: pressure, traction, atavistic, and aberrant epiphysis. You may remember with the mnemonic PTAA if you like. If you don't know what is epiphysis, please have a look at my previous video on epiphysis, epiphyseal plate, etc. So let us right away go to what is a pressure epiphysis. This illustration shows the proximal end of the femur bone articulating with the hip bone. You can notice that the weight transmission line goes through this pathway through the hip bone and the femur. So here you can see that within the head of the femur, you can see that there is a formation of an epiphysis. And that, since it is in the location of the weight transmission line, it is known as a pressure epiphysis. Let us have a look at a series of x-rays in a young child of 9 months age, 11 months age, and older child. And you can see the location of the epiphyseal center, the secondary ossification center, in over here, here, and here. And in the last one, you can see the clear formation of a epiphyseal plate between this epiphysis and the metaphysis. All right, next we will see what a traction epiphysis is, also called by clinicians as traction apophysis or simply as apophysis. These secondary ossification centers are in non-weight-bearing areas, and that's the difference with what you saw in pressure epiphysis. And these are seen in locations where you have muscle pulls. Traction epiphysis, if they are not fused, can be easily mistaken for fractures. You may mistake it for an avulsion fracture. Let us have a look at the x-ray of a child's elbow, which is one of the common sites of injuries. And it's very important to note that this, and this are the lateral epicondyle, medial epicondyle, and the olecranon. And these locations are not fractures. They are all secondary ossification centers. And it is very important to note whether it is a secondary ossification center or a fracture, and that depends on the age of the child and also the order in which the structures are ossified in these regions. This is the importance of knowing this traction apophysis. Before going further, let us quickly compare the pressure and traction epiphysis. The head of the femur is a pressure epiphysis, while the greater trochanter and the lesser trochanter are traction epiphysis because they are locations of muscle pulls. And one more point that I want to stress here is the location of the capsule. The capsule is attached like this, and you can notice that the pressure epiphysis is within the capsule. That means it is within the joint, while the traction epiphysis are outside the capsule, that is outside the joint or extracapsular. This is the same case if you look at the proximal end of the humerus also, where you can see the head of the humerus is a pressure epiphysis, and the greater and the lesser tubercles are traction epiphysis. All right, let's move on to the next epiphysis, and that is called the atavistic epiphysis. The classic example of atavistic epiphysis is the coracoid process. It means that it is a phylogenetically independent bone. That means in a lower animal, this bone can be separate bone, especially in monotremes, it can be separate bone. But in humans, it got fused with the scapula. Another example of an atavistic epiphysis is the os trigonum of the talus. Though it's part of the talus usually, it can be a separate bone sometimes, and it should not be missed for a fracture. All right, we go to the last type. It's called the aberrant epiphysis. To understand the aberrant epiphysis, you need to have a look at an x-ray of a normal hand of a child. So in this 11-year-old child's x-ray, you can have a look at the epiphyseal plates in the metacarpals. Okay, they are classically located at second to fourth metacarpals in the head region. And in the first metacarpal, it is located in the base. This is the normal configuration in a child's hand. Now, what is aberrant epiphysis? In an aberrant epiphysis, you will have an extra epiphyseal plate. Okay, in this case, you can see that it is located in the second metacarpal base. And this has another name. It is also called pseudo-epiphysis. All right, that was a lot. And quickly, let us summarize. There are four types of epiphysis: pressure epiphysis, traction epiphysis, exemplified by this picture. This is a pressure epiphysis and these two attraction epiphysis. Atavistic epiphysis, classic one is the coracoid process. And aberrant epiphysis, you can occasionally get that in the base of the second to fourth metacarpals. Thank you so much for your patient listening.